Hi, this is Mike Rozanik. I'm here at World of Concrete, and I'm talking with Vanguard Engine Marketing Manager Jim Cross, and we're talking about your new single-cylinder engine that you are just unveiling for the first time here. This is not the typical engine introduction that we're used to seeing.
Right, Mike. We actually approached it a little differently in that we actually went out and asked customers what they wanted locally for this line of engine before we ever even decided to start designing it. And they told us, interesting enough, out of the top 10 things that they wanted out of an engine in this category, three of them had nothing to do with the engine. It was integrated support, warranty, and those types of things, parts availability, the things that keep those people looking up in front of.
The other thing is, talk a little bit about, you did some key design enhancements in terms of engine starting, filtration, fuel tolerance, and fuel issues. Talk a little bit about this.
Yeah, you're right. Like, with this ground-up design and starting with the customer, we're able to look at everything and all the integrated systems with it. So we looked at the user experience, the starting, the stale fuel issues, and how do you address those with inflated wetted surface on the carburetor, for example. When is this a corrosion fuel? When we started, we did some things with the starting pump and the recoil and to allow for an easier start, and also with the carburation system to allow for better cold weather starting. So we dressed up with the air filtration, we're very excited. We have standard cyclonic air filtration. It really is a two-step process. One, you've got the chamber itself, but then we have this really advanced filter media, proprietary auto shed technology that's tuned to the vibration signature of the engine to shed away dust and debris into the airstream and remove it from the airstream before it ever reaches the rest of the process. So it's a really comprehensive solution we're able to do.
And also, we're looking at one of the engines here. In terms of dimensions and control schemes of how an engine like this is controlled in a machine, you really set it up to make it easier for OEMs. How did you do that?
Yeah, you're right, Mike. We had to really address the marketplace. Again, it's not about us. It's about what is easier for the entire channel, from an OEM to a dealer to an end user. So first build, all the way to the retrofit, the engine had to be an easy drop-in replacement. So we looked at things like bolt patterns, shaft heights, control of travel and direction. So it's an easy swap out and alternative for those customers for some of the engines are already in the marketplace.
In terms of what's going to be the overall horsepower range and what's the availability of the engine?
Yeah, that's a really great question. It is a line of engine. And ironically, right, realistically, we're building each one as its own individual engine. There'll be learnings, of course. But we'll start with our, this year we'll be introducing a 6.5 horsepower 203cc engine. Next year, we'll be introducing a 408cc 13 horsepower engine. After that, a 160cc as well as a 200 down the year after that. Anywhere from the 160 to about 5 horsepower, and then the 300cc to be about 10.
And these are going to be available, marketed globally, and supported globally.
Yeah, absolutely. Everything we do in this category, in this space, as you know, it is global applications. There's global manufacturers that build internationally, distribute globally, and then how we use these carriers from region to region. So we're really focusing on a global spec, again, that will make a universal manufacturer.
So that's the story here on Breaking New Engines in World of Concrete. You can read all about the January issue of Diesel Progress.